Are you troubled by strange noises in the middle of the night?
Do you experience feelings of dread in your basement or attic?
Have you or any of your family ever seen a spook, specter, or ghost?
If the answer is yes, then don't wait another minute. Pick up your phone and call the professional.
This is Ghostbusters, specifically Ghostbusters 1984. We all know it as the cultural shock that it became and how significant it was to pop culture as we know it. In the midst of Frozen Empire coming out and 1 week of the time of me writing this, I decided to take a look back at what was the juggernaut of a movie which took the world by storm, rewinding back 40 years into the 80s. Following the success of SNL and the Blues Brothers in 1981, Dan Aykroyd wrote the original treatment for Ghostmasters, which would have been about ghostbusting, being a common profession in the far future intended to star him and the late John Belushi, which Dan Aykroyd got the idea of writing after reading an article of quantum physics and parapsychology. But after Belushi's passing, they approached the late Harold Ramis to help rewrite the script, who at the time just finished directing National Lampoon's Vacation starring Chevy Chase. And to direct the movie, they approached Ivan Reitman, who at the time was known for directing movies such as Stripes and Meatballs.
Concept. I just finished directing National Lampoon's Vacation, the first one. And I really looked forward to working with Bill and Danny and Ivan on this one. I love the premise, and Ivan and I really saw eye to eye on how to reshape the script.
When looking at the effects and the script for the movie, Reitman deemed it impossible from all the ideas Aykroyd wanted to implement, such as the many forms of Gozer. Eventually, Reitman pitched the idea to Columbia Pictures to be set in a more contemporary setting, to be set in modern New York. Columbia Pictures granted them a budget of $25 to $30 million, but they only had a year to film due to Columbia's picture shooting schedule. So before production had even started, they were already on crunch time, with 2.5 weeks of rewriting the script and less than 5 months to shoot. Ghostbusters came out officially on June 8, 1984, and the rest is history. Dan plays Ray Stantz, who is arguably the main character and the heart of the team, and is the optimist of the bunch, while Peter Venkman doesn't take anything seriously and is more interested on chasing ladies than doing real work with ghosts. Egon is the brain of the team and is shown to be rather serious in his work, while also having a knack for snacking a lot. Winston Zeddemore is the fourth Ghostbuster they hired after the increase of demand for the Ghostbusters and makes it clear he just needs a steady paycheck. The movie opens outside of a library, coming to the inside. We follow a librarian doing her job like any other day. We get a long shot of the librarian walking down before we see her get spooked by something we don't see, but something we hear. We cut to Peter, the first Ghostbuster we are introduced to, who is played by Bill Murray. Then Ray Stantz, who is played by Dan Aykroyd, walks in to Peter about the ghost sighting which occurred at the library. They grab their friend Egon, who Ray appears to be close with, and they go to the library to check out the phenomenon they heard of, which leads them to encounter just that, a ghost. After their encounter with the ghost, they go back to the university they work at, only to find out they've been fired by the university dean, dismissing the idea of any ghost. Following a paranormal encounter in her apartment, we meet Dana Barrett, who visits the Ghostbusters. She recounts witnessing a demonic dog-like creature in her refrigerator, uttering the word Zool. Ray and Egon research Zool and details of Dana's building, while Peter inspects her apartment and unsuccessfully attempts to seduce her. The Ghostbusters are hired to remove a glutinous ghost, Slimer, from the Sedgwick Hotel. Having failed to properly test their equipment, Egon warns the group that crossing the energy streams of their proton pack weapons could cause a catastrophic explosion. They capture the ghost and deposit it into the ecto-containment unit under the firehouse. Supernatural activity is rapidly increasing across the city, and the Ghostbusters become famous. They hire a fourth member, Winston Zeddemore, who, fun fact, was originally supposed to be played by Eddie Murphy, but turned down the role. suspicious of the Ghostbusters, environmentalist agent Walter Peck asks to reevaluate their equipment, but Peter refuses to let him. Egon warns that the containment unit is nearing captivity and supernatural energy is surging across the city. Peter meets with Dana to inform her that Zool was a demigod worshipped as a servant to Gozer the Gozerian. Upon returning home, she is possessed by Zool. A similar entity possesses her neighbor, Louis Tully. Peter arrives and finds the possessed Dana claiming to be the gatekeeper. Louis is brought to Egon by police officers and claims he is Vince Clotho, the Keymaster. The Ghostbusters agree they must keep the pair separated. Peck returns with law enforcement and city workers to have the Ghostbusters arrested and their containment unit deactivated, causing an explosion that releases the captured ghosts. Louis slash Vince escapes the confusion and makes his way to the apartment building to join Zool slash Dana. In jail, Ray and Egon reveal that Ivo Shando, leader of a grocer worshipper cult in the 21st century, designed Dana's building to function as an antenna to attract and concentrate spiritual energy to summon Gozer and bring about the apocalypse. Faced with supernatural chaos across the city, the Ghostbusters convince the mayor to release them. The Ghostbusters travel to a hidden temple located on the top of the building as Dana and Louis open the gate between dimensions and transform into demonic dogs. Gozer appears as a woman and attacks the Ghostbusters, then disappears when they attempt to retaliate. Her disembodied voice demands the Ghostbusters to choose the form of the Destructor. Ray inadvertently recalls a beloved corporate mascot from his childhood, and Gozer reappears as a gigantic Stay Puft Marshmallow Man that begins destroying the city. Against his earlier advice, Egon instructs the team to cross their proton energy streams at the dimensional gate. The resulting explosion destroys Gozer's avatar, banishing back to its dimension and closes the gateway. The Ghostbusters rescue Dana and Louis from the wreckage and are welcomed on the street as heroes. Before we end the video, I want to talk about the special effects of the movie because boy do I love them. From the dark fantasy imagery to the physical practical effects, special effects master Richard Idlund, who had worked on Star Wars and the same year 2010 special effects, had opened up his own studio with the first film on his slate to be Ghostbusters. Some of the best effects in the movie being the gadgets the Ghostbusters use themselves, or the scene where Peck causes all the ghosts to escape to the close-ups of the ghosts themselves. Richard Edlund also liked to work with large format celluloid 65mm. When we see the close-ups of Slimer, they look great, even today. With such clear resolution, no detail goes missing. And with the technology they used for the beams, they used 5 layers of animated beams mixed with miniature explosions, which were later printed on an optical printer. Ghostbusters was nominated for its special effects at the Oscars, but even then, with all the cool special effects and techniques they used, it ultimately lost to Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom. There you have it. That's my retrospective and brief summary and analysis of the movie. Thank you for listening if you made it this far into the video. That's all about it.
To Taco Night at the Andersons.
Hey, it's a Stay Puft Marshmallow Man!
Taco Night is also movie night at the Andersons.
Get a coupon for a free Blockbuster video when you bring home the new Grande meal from Taco Bell. It's a mountain of food for just
$9.99. 1, 2, 3,
wow, let's make s'mores.
Until next time.